have a habit of attaching my happiness to my goals. It is a pretty bad habit because the more happiness I expect to urge from hitting my goal, the more I fear missing my goal over time. This fear of failure causes me to line small safe goals I do know I can hit by playing it safe and setting small goals. I stop forcing myself to grow and achieve extraordinary leads to my life. Within the book The Code of the Extraordinary Mind, author Vishen Lakhiani outlines an excellent goal setting method to cut back the fear of failure and maximize personal growth. His goal setting method involves two phases. The primary phase involves reducing the fear of failure by establishing internal self-fueled goals that generate happiness. These self-fueled goals are entirely within our control, and that we can do them at any time during the day to experience a burst of happiness with a reliable source of happiness. We free ourselves to require chances and risk failure, because irrespective of what happens, we will always find some way to be happy. And in phase two, ask yourself the three most vital inquiries to set goals that maximize your personal growth and result in extraordinary results. Let's dive in and explore this two-phase approach to goal setting. Phase darling, establish a collection of self-fueled end goals. In a moment of deep reflection at the Burning Man Festival within the Nevada desert, author Vishen Lakhiani realized the three goals he needed to be happy were outside of his control. His three goals were being loved by his wife, reading a book every week, and experiencing more travel adventure in his life. He realized that he may not feel loved by his wife Christina if she happened to possess a nasty day and wasn't feeling particularly loving, and he would fail to read a book every week and skill more travel and adventure in his life if he had a crisis at work and he did not have enough time to read a complete book or escape to a different country to possess a replacement adventure. So he distilled each of those goals to the bottom expert, and he was seeking. He realized that his goal of being loved by his wife was actually be surrounded by love. He realized that his goal of reading a book every week was the identical as always be learning and growing. And he realized that the goal of experiencing more travel and adventure in his life was the identical as having amazing human experiences. Author Vishen Lakhiani says, these new goals are directly within my very own power. Nobody can take these far away from me. This implies no failure can stop me. I can be homeless and alone sleeping on the streets of latest York City, but I can still be surrounded by love because my love comes from within. Meaning he can just visualize the people he loves, which can provide him with a sense of affection. And he says, I can learn and grow as long as I can find an old newspaper or a throwaway book to read, and that I can even have beautiful human experiences because I see the enjoyment in existence even just walking through common. I've got very similar self goals to Vishen Lakhiani, because quite frankly the sentiments of affection, growth and amazing experiences are fundamental human needs. They create up the highest tiers of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. My self-fueled goal of feeling loved will be achieved in mere 5 seconds by closing my eyes and thinking of three friends or members of the family I'm thankful for, and so imagining hugging them and feeling my love for them. It doesn't matter if I just had a fight with a devotee, I can reliably hit this goal and feel happy. Will my self-fueled goal of growing and attaining more knowledge may be achieved in 60 seconds or less by getting rid of my phone anytime during the day, opening up a book on my Kindle app and highlighting some insights. I found that this goal is reliable thanks to get a burst of joy regardless of what setbacks I encounter during the day. And my self-fueled goal of getting amazing experiences are often achieved by being attentive to my breath for 10 seconds. This helps me to comprehend that time breathing all day automatically and subconsciously. By taking 10 seconds to specialize in this fact, I'm stuffed with appreciation and joy. So what are your goals that you just fuel yourself, and what goals are you able to achieve that are completely within your control? Generate happiness on demand when it's you have got a collection of fuel sales goals. It sounds like you've got an internal coin machine founded to win. When you pull goose with a bunch of auto-fuel targets in situ, you'll get near your other targets with nothing to lose. You'll found that your eyes are big bold goals that increase your capabilities and cause extraordinary results. And this results in the second stage within the second phase of Vishen Lakhiani's goal setting approach. We set exciting goals to meet that increase our personal growth and lead us to extraordinary results by asking three questions. Important first, if time and money were nothing and that I did not have to ask anyone's permission, what experiences would I need to have? Second, how would I want to grow so as to possess these experiences? And third, as a result of growth, how would I be able to respond? a bent to the planet after you ask what experience I need if time and money weren't my thing and that I did not have to fire it. Then you begin to determine a future that motivates you and pushes you forward. After I ask this question, I see myself as liberal to own my business online and have the financial resources and adaptability to travel with my family at any time during the year. By asking the second question, how will I would like to grow so as to get those experiences that you simply see because the person you must become so as to achieve those experiences. If I need to enjoy the experience of traveling with my family at any time and at any time, Mukin, able to vertical bar aisle, need the abilities to develop a thriving online business and become a world famous mentor in productivity. So finally ask the question as a result of developing how will I be able to return to the globe. You're thinking that about how the talents you possess, the e-developer, will facilitate your return the value more highly to me by having become a world renowned productivity teacher and being great at telling stories. I can inspire more people to require action and provides them the tools they have to attain great ends up in their lives. Once you ask yourself these three questions, it's okay if the initial experience you would like seems a small amount absurd initially if it excites you and ends up in growth, which growth results in the contribution. As an example, you would like to sound important and meaningful and have the experience of speaking on stage at a TED conference. This seems a bit self-indulgent, but that's fine. On your class chair, TED Talk will need to grow as somebody's being, and after your TED Talk, many folks are going to be inspired to try to the identical at the top of extraordinary minds. Don't tie their happiness to each goal. Instead, they find a group of self-fueling goals to come up with happiness reliably, so they will set goals great and follow them without losing anything. These big goals, by wondering the experiences they require, how they must evolve into how those experiences and what they're going to be ready to contribute to the planet as a result of that. By pursuing these goals, they're not only happy but they need been achieved, and this was the essential message that I gathered from The Symbol of Reason, The Extraordinary by Vishen Lakhiani. It is a great book that challenges the established order. Highly recommend it. Thanks for watching.